Molly Meldrum in an induced coma and fighting for life after undergoing surgery following a heavy fall at his Melbourne home. 6 a.m. Friday the 16th of December. Good morning everyone, I'm Ron Wilson.
And I'm Natasha Rexelby. Welcome to 10's Early News. Also this morning, leadership speculation continues to weigh on Julia Gillard following her cabinet reshuffle with a key minister refusing to endorse the PM.
In sport, a two-month standoff between the AFL and its players is over, with both parties finally agreeing to a deal which will net the players more than $1 billion.
And in finance, Hungary and the Czech Republic join Great Britain in opposing the latest treaty to rescue the euro.
Ian Molly Meldrum is fighting for life in Melbourne after suffering critical injuries in a fall at his Melbourne home. The icon of the Australian music industry has undergone surgery and has been placed in an induced coma.
The distinctive walls of Molly Meldrum's home flanked by ambulances as crews worked to save his life. Meldrum was hanging Christmas decorations ahead of a weekend party at his Melbourne home when he fell up to 3 metres, suffering severe head and chest injuries, a collapsed lung and multiple broken bones. Close friend and colleague Mark Clemens said the next 24 hours will prove crucial.
Injuries to his chest area and to his head region. He was rushed to hospital here at the Alfred.
It's believed Meldrum wasn't breathing when he was found by his gardener. He was transported to hospital where he was placed in an induced coma and underwent emergency surgery.
He sustained a pretty heavy hit when he fell, and the doctors are obviously working in earnest.
Social media has been flooded with messages of support from stars and friends in the music industry. Russell Crowe said, sending Ian Meldrum love, thinking of you, mate. Danny Minogue said, thinking of Molly Meldrum, while her sister Kylie tweeted, sending lots of love to Molly Meldrum. Get well soon. Meldrum's family and close friends remain by his bedside. Chris O'Keefe, 10 News.
Police are at a Brisbane primary school which has been severely damaged by fire overnight. The Eagle Junction Primary School was well alight when firefighters were called at around 1 o'clock this morning. The administration building and the library were destroyed in the blaze, which is being treated as suspicious.
It's a pretty awful thing to have something like this happen to your school. So personally, you always feel as though this is not a good thing.
Nearby residents were told to keep their doors and windows shut due to the large amount of smoke in the area. A couple will face court today following a high-speed police chase. Officers began the pursuit after reports of a stolen high-performance Ford speeding along a freeway north of Sydney. It's alleged the couple then abandoned that vehicle and carjacked a BMW at gunpoint. The chase lasted for more than an hour. Officers used road spikes and rammed the BMW to bring the ordeal to an end. A handgun was reportedly found near the scene. Massive pay rises for federal politicians and top public servants have been unveiled. The Prime Minister gets a pay rise of more than $100,000, taking her salary to almost $500,000. But travel perks have been slashed, including the gold pass.
The lurks and the perks are taken away.
For the first time, shadow ministers are recognised with a $90,000 boost to their incomes. After nearly 9 years, the war in Iraq is officially over. Troops have lowered and retired the flag of US Forces Iraq during a ceremony in Baghdad. In army tradition, the flag was wrapped in camouflage, formally casing it. US Defence Secretary Leon Panetta flew in for the occasion and told troops they leave Iraq with lasting pride. The war cost America $800 billion and claimed the lives of 4,500 soldiers. The 4,000 US troops still in Iraq will be home by the end of the year. Former French President Jacques Chirac has been found guilty of embezzling public funds. A court found the 79-year-old created fake jobs to illegally finance the Conservative Party while he was the mayor of Paris. Chirac repeatedly denied any wrongdoing, but he didn't take part in the trial after doctors determined he suffers from severe memory lapses. Chirac was given a suspended 2-year prison sentence. He is France's first former leader to be convicted since the World War II era. 143 people have been killed in eastern India after drinking a toxic batch of bootleg liquor laced with methanol. Dozens of other people have been rushed to hospital and treated for poisoning. Most of the victims are labourers, street hawkers and rickshaw drivers. Many of their grieving families wailed in the streets calling for justice. Illegal liquor operations flourish in the slums, popular among those who can't afford sanctioned alcohol. Well, it was a happy dash back into the sea for 40 little blue penguins in New Zealand. The birds had all been rescued, slicked with oil, following October's catastrophic spill when the container ship Rena breached off the coast of Tauranga. After being cleaned up and nursed back to health, they were finally let loose, racing to get back into the ocean. This was the last group of the rescued penguins to be released. Sports news, and a flamboyant Englishman dressed in purple as the outright leader of the Australian Masters golf tournament. Ian Poulter carded a 6-under 65 to lead Australia's Ashley Hall by a stroke. World number one Luke Donald is 2-under, while defending champion Stuart Appleby teed off despite a back injury.
The day started with drama for the defending champion. A last-minute fitness test for Stuart Appleby, pushing his injured back through the pain barrier with any help he could, and then letting officials know he was right to go. His morning session finished at 1-under the card with a 70, keeping his hopes alive. Also in the early groups, world number one Luke Donald, who completed a solid 2-under. Englishman Ian Poulter put his name atop the leaderboard with an opening round 6-under 65. From purple to green, and Nathan produced the shot of the day, leaving the putter in the bag after this effort on the par 4 third.
Oh, this could nearly go in. This could be in.
Yes, sir!
Not related, but also firing well, was former champ Richard Green, who produced this approach at the second. Peter Senior was flying the flag for the veterans, out of the bunker and back in the game. While Italian teenager Matteo Manassaro had a tough day with a couple of rare highlights.
Landed right next to the flag, Aussie, but it screwed back about 25 feet down the green.
After a controversial fortnight, Robert Allenby was struggling to find his A-game. In the trees and wasting chances on the greens, but he did occasionally redeem himself.
There's one get-out-of-jail card used.
While Allenby has claimed the Triple Crown, the man chasing that slice of history, Greg Chalmers, had zeroed in his targeting almost to perfection.
Brilliant from Greg Chalmers. He's made a couple of great scrambles so far.
Ian Cohen, 10 News.
Tonight, one of the biggest ventures in domestic cricket history will get underway with the opening of the Big Bash League. The clocks will be wound back with former Test teammates Brett Lee, Stuart McGill and Matthew Hayden all taking part. While Hayden has called for calm from the national selectors, saying it takes time for young players to develop.
A lot of guys at 28, 29 actually come into the game. That's why I don't agree with Greg Chappell's youth policy. I think it takes a long time to master your game and to learn about it.
The Sydney Sixers take on the Brisbane Heat in Sydney tonight. Time for all the morning's finance news now with Natasha Exelby. Tash, good morning to you. Look, it's obviously the busiest time of the year for retailers, sure, leading up to Christmas. JB Hi-Fi, though, what's wrong? They're not smiling.
Far from it, Ronnie. JB Hi-Fi, the retailer, surprised the market by forecasting a pre-Christmas downgrade. Profit for the six-month period to the end of December will be 5% down on last year. The company is blaming price discounting among retailers trying to clear stock for the drop in profit. Its policy of matching any marked price has come back to bite it, with the price of televisions dropping by up to 25%. In more trouble for the embattled Eurozone, Hungary and the Czech Republic won't join a European Union treaty aimed at tackling the debt crisis if it means giving up their country's independent tax policies. It comes as large demonstrations were held right across Europe over austerity measures. In Greece, thousands of angry pensioners hit the streets of Athens to protest pension cuts. A small scuffle broke out between an elderly man and police as the group descended on Parliament. Inside, the Prime Minister was negotiating terms of a second massive rescue package. Meanwhile, in Italy, firefighters protested outside of Parliament. They're angry over an austerity package aimed at persuading markets the country can get its finances under control. But despite these problems, the US stocks are trading higher this morning, and we have the Spaniards to thank for that. Overnight, Spain successfully auctioned off some solid debt, and that certainly calmed some nerves in Europe. The Dow Jones is currently up 80 points and the Nasdaq 7. Across to Europe, the FTSE, the CAC and the DAX all made gains following data showing inflation will remain steady, which means there's more room for a rate cut. The contrast could not be more stark in Asia, though. The Nikkei hit a two-week low and the Hang Seng was obliterated, but it is likely to rebound well off the back of Europe's gains overnight. To the commodities, and oil is trading steady at $94 a barrel. Gold is also steady. To the currency crosses, and one Aussie dollar buys 99 US cents and 76 euro cents. Our market closed in negative territory yesterday. The All Ords was down 51 points. But if we go on the results out of Europe, it does look like it will be a positive end to the week.